off. The extent of damage and destruction from Friday's tornadoes is mind-boggling. 38 deaths are being blamed now on the storms, and that number continues to grow. Experts spent the day on the ground surveying the damage in Henryville, Indiana. That's 20 miles north of Louisville, while residents there started the process of cleaning up. Daniel Kemp has been there all afternoon. He joins us now live with the very latest on this. Daniel?
Well, Rick, Henryville is quiet tonight. Only the hum of generators can be heard throughout the area. That's because cops tonight are keeping a close eye on who comes in.
Yes, sir. How can I help you?
In a town thrown about by storms.
Just turn your right turn signal on and watch your cross traffic, okay?
Safety becomes top priority.
Do you not live here?
No,
okay.
Sorry.
I cannot let you in unless you live here.
Okay. A city curfew now keeps onlookers out. After nightfall, only residents are allowed back to their homes or what's left of them.
I mean, it's a total loss. We lost the house, the barn, the garage is not even there anymore.
Terrence and Paula Bates are staying at a hotel as temperatures drop. Authorities say few are actually seeking refuge in shelters like this one here at Charlestown High School.
We just welcome people to come in here and have a warm place to rest their head and get some food.
Experts tell us it was an EF4 tornado that left more than 50 miles of devastation and deaths.
It's in that violent category that most tornadoes never come anywhere near to.
14 people have died as a result of the storm. One of them, we're told, lived here on Spieth Road.
He was a farmer just like the rest of us. He was a good man and a good person.
Still for others, signs of improvements are showing.
The number of phone calls that we had received on people wanting to check on friends, neighbors, and family, those have diminished almost to zero.
In a community where folks say a helping hand isn't hard to find.
It is very amazing that the people came out like they have.
And that curfew continues until 6 o'clock in the morning. We're told Monday is when crews will start going block by block, cleaning up the mess. Live in Henryville tonight, I'm Daniel Kemp, WLKY News.